Hi to all. Today we are going to discuss about macronutrients and also micronutrients. So what is a nutrient? Okay, nutrients means these are chemical substances, means which are required for proper growth and functioning of all the living organisms including plants and animals. And these nutrients are also called as essential elements. Why these are essential elements means? Because in the absence of these chemicals, these plants and animals cannot complete their life cycle. So that's why these nutrients are called as essential elements. So here the important nutrients are required by plants for their proper growth. They are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, chloride, sulfur, magnesium, iron, manganese, copper, zinc, molybdenum, boron, nickel. Here, except these carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, the remaining all the elements are absorbed from the soil as inorganic ions by the root cells. In plants, these nutrients are classified into two categories based on how much quantity are required by the cells. So these are two types. One is the micronutrients, another one is the macronutrients. Micronutrients means which are required in the less amount, those are called micronutrients. And macronutrients means which are needed in large amount, those are called macronutrients. So these micronutrients are iron, copper, iodine, manganese, boron, molybdenum, zinc, cobalt. And these macronutrients are furtherly classified into two types. One is the primary nutrients, another one is the secondary nutrients. So primary nutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and secondary nutrients are calcium, magnesium, sulfur. And differences between these micronutrients and also macronutrients. So these macronutrients are required in small quantity, and these macronutrients are required in large quantity. And these micronutrients are helps in the photosynthesis, and also these are participate in the different reactions of nitrogen fixation, and these are helping to plant growth and also development. And also here these are copper, iron, molybdenum, these are active during the oxidation and reductase reactions. And these macronutrients are abundantly present in the plant body, and these are present in the minute concentration in plant body. And these are macronutrients present in the plant cells more than 1 milligrams per grams of their dry weight, and these are present less than 1 milligram of gram their dry weight. And these macronutrients are called as major elements, and these micronutrients are called as trace elements. And these are classified into two groups: primary nutrients, secondary nutrients, and these are not furtherly classified. And these macronutrients are included with minerals, and some are non-minerals, and these micronutrients are completely minerals. And also here these minerals are completely absorbed through the roots, and except these carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and here also these are absorbed through the roots. And let's we have discuss about micronutrients. Micronutrients means which elements are needed in or require small amounts, those are called micronutrients. So the first one, iron, it is a structural component of hemoglobin. Iron is a structural component of hemoglobin, and it is the part of cytochrome and also ferredaxin, and this iron stimulates the synthesis of chlorophyll in plants, and also it is strongly associated with the protein metabolism, and also essential in the enzyme system in plant metabolism. And the enzymes includes like catalase and peroxidase and cytochrome oxidase and other cytochromes. It is a structural component of hemoglobin, and also it is the part of cytochrome and pyridoxin, and it stimulates the synthesis of chlorophyll, and it is strongly associated with the protein metabolism, and also it is present in the essential in the enzyme system in plant metabolism. The enzymes are includes like catalase, peroxidase and cytochrome oxidase and other cytochromes. And the next one, copper, it is the structural component of hemocyanin, and also it is the activator of cytochrome oxidase enzyme. Cytochrome oxidase enzyme, and also this copper helps in the synthesis or stability of chlorophyll and other plant pigments, and also it is essential in several plant enzyme systems which are involved in the photosynthesis. It is a structural component of hemocyanin, and also it is the activator of cytochrome oxidase enzyme, and it helps in the synthesis of hemoglobin, and these copper have a role in the synthesis of stability of chlorophyll and other plant pigments, and also it is essential in several plant enzyme systems which are involved in the photosynthesis. And the next one, iodine, so it is a part of the thyroxine hormone, and also it helps in the development of brain and reproductive organs. It is a part of thyroxine hormone, and also it helps to develop brain and also reproductive organ. And the next one, manganese, it is involved in the oxidation and reduction process in photosynthesis, and also it is necessary in photosystem too, where it participate in the photolysis. It is involved in the oxidation and reduction process of photosynthesis, and also it is necessary in photosystem too, where it participate in photolysis. And these manganese activate indolestic acid oxidases. And the next one, boron. Boron has been promote root growth. This boron has been shown to promote root growth, and also it is essential for pollen germination and growth of pollen tube. It helps to promote the root growth, and also it essential for pollen germination and also growth of pollen tube. And the next one, molybdenum, it is a necessary component of major enzymes in plants, nitrate reductase and also nitrogenase, which are required for normal assimilation of nitrogen. And also it is required by soil microorganisms for nitrogen fixation in the soil. This molybdenum is a necessary component of major enzymes in plants like nitrate reductase and nitrogenase, which are required for the normal assimilation of nitrogen. And also it is required by some soil microorganisms for the nitrogen fixation in soil. And the next one, zinc has a role in RNA and protein synthesis. And also the enzyme carbonic anhydrase is specifically activated by zinc, and the essential components of several metals on enzymes in plants. And also zinc is required in the synthesis of tryptophan in turn for the formation of indole acetic acid in plants. This zinc is important role as RNA and protein synthesis, and also this zinc activates the enzyme carbonic anhydrase, and also it is essential component for several metal and enzymes in plants. And zinc is required for the synthesis of tryptophan in turn for the formation of indole acetic acid in plants. And the last one, cobalt. It is important constituent of vitamin B12, and also this cobalt stimulates the production of hormones and like erythropoietin. This is promotes erythropoiesis. It is important constituent of vitamin B12, and it stimulates production of hormones like erythropoietin, and which promotes the erythropoiesis. And these all are the micronutrients: iron, copper, iodine, magnesium, molybdenum, zinc, boron, cobalt. And next we have to discuss about macronutrients. So these macronutrients are classified in two types: one, primary, and secondary. So nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, these are three are the primary nutrients. So first we have to see in carbon. So this carbon is a structural component of organic compounds like proteins, lipids, carbohydrates, vitamins and also nucleic acid. And also it is participated in the photosynthesis process. And the next, hydrogen. It is a structural component of organic compounds and also structural component of water, and it participates in the photosynthesis. And the next, nitrogen. So nitrogen is biologically combined with carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur to create amino acids, which are the building blocks of the proteins. And it is a structural component of all amino acids, purines and pyrimidines. And also this nitrogen is a major part of the chlorophyll molecule, and it is necessary for photosynthesis. And also this nitrogen helps somatic growth in plants. So it is biologically combined with the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur, and these are create amino acids, which are building blocks of the protein. And also this structural component of all amino acids, purines and pyrimidines, and also it helps the somatic growth in plants. And this nitrogen plays a major part of the chlorophyll molecule, and it is necessary for the photosynthesis. And also it is needed for all enzymatic reactions which is occurs in the plant. And next, phosphorus, it is a structural component of ATP, ADP, NAD, NADP and also DNA, and also it is the structural component of bones, teeth and also some artificial fertilizers. And also during the photosynthesis and respiration process, this phosphorus plays a major role through these transport and storage of energy as ADP, ATP, DPN, TPN. Adenosine diphosphate, adenosine triphosphate, triphosphonucleic acid, triphosphonucleic acid. So during the photosynthesis and respiration process, this phosphorus plays a major role in energy storage and also transfer as ADP, ATP, DPN, TPN. And also this phosphorus acid helps to root development and flower initiation and also seed and fruit development. And also several seeds have highest concentration of phosphorus in a mature plants. And the next one, potassium. This potassium participates in the transmission of nerve impulse, and also it is a structural component of intracellular fluid, and it is participates in the opening and closing of stomata. These stomata of leaves are control transpiration. During the photosynthesis, this potassium plays a major role of maintaining the balance of electrical charges at the site of ATP production. It is participate in the transmission of nerve impulse, and also it is the structural component of cellular fluid, and also it's participate in the opening and also closing stomata. These stomata of leaves are controls transpiration, and also photosynthesis process, potassium plays a major role during the maintaining the balance of electrical charges at the site of ATP production. And disease resistance in plants into the size of grains and seeds. And these three are the secondary nutrients: magnesium, sulfur, chloride. Magnesium, it is the structural component of chlorophyll, and also it helps the formation of bones and teeth, and also it is participates in protein, lipid, carbohydrates metabolism, and also it acts as a cofactor in the several enzymatic reactions that activate the phosphorylation processes, and also it assists the movement of sugars within the plant. Magnesium is a structural component of chlorophyll, and it helps to formation of bones and teeth, and also participate protein, lipid, carbohydrate metabolism, and also it acts as cofactor in the several enzymatic reactions, and these reactions that activate phosphorylation processes, and also it assists the movement of sugars within a plant. And the next, sulfur, it is the structural component of insulin hormone, and also cytosine, methionine, cysteine, thiamine, biotin. It is the structural component of insulin hormone, and for cytosine, methionine, thiamine, cysteine and biotin, and it is essentially informing the plant proteins because it is a constituent of certain amino acids. It is essentially informing plant proteins because it is a constituent of certain amino acids, and it is actively involved in metabolism of vitamin B, biotin and thiamine, and coenzyme A. And the next, chloride. It maintains the osmotic pressure of blood and also body fluids, and it helps in the cell division in leaves, and these chlorine participate in the photolysis of water in light phase of photosynthesis, and also this chlorine found in the many bacteria and fungi, and it increase the cell osmotic pressure and water contents of plant tissues. This chloride maintains the osmotic pressure of blood and also body fluids, and also it helps in the cell division in leaves, and also this chlorine participate in photolysis of water in light phase of photosynthesis, and also it is present in many bacteria and fungi, and also it increase the cell osmotic pressure and water content in plant tissues. And the last one, calcium. It is the structural component of bones, teeth and shells, and it participate in the blood coagulation and also muscle contraction, and this calcium plays a major role in the formation of cell wall membrane, and also this calcium is an activator several enzyme systems in photosynthesis and also carbohydrate transfer, and also this calcium essential for the seed production in peanuts. Calcium, it is the structural component of bones, teeth, shells, and also it participate blood coagulation and also muscle contraction, and also this calcium plays a major role in the formation of cell wall membrane, and also it is an activator of several enzyme system which are participate in the photoprotein synthesis and carbohydrate transfer, and also this calcium is essential for the seed production. So it's about the micronutrients and macronutrients. Thank you.